Hey PE students, Mr. Lustig here. Today we are going to teach you how to underhand throw, how to toss the ball, how to toss the other objects. Why would you want to learn how to underhand throw? Well, you could toss the keys to your mom and dad, and if it's not accurate, you might break something in the house. But we could also use it for bowling. Maybe you like to play cornhole. Maybe you like to play horseshoes. There are a lot of sports, there are a lot of games where we use an underhand throw. Maybe we just want to play catch with a friend. So I'm going to teach you the basics. The first thing I want to talk about is your hand position. So when we underhand throw, we want to use an open hand, fingers slightly spread, and the palm up. So we're gonna step and just do a nice easy toss with our hand. The next thing I want to talk about is our hand in relation to our body. We want to have our hand up right in front of our shoulder, and when we swing our arm, we would like the arm to go straight through along the side of your body right in front of your shoulder. Here's a side view. We want it to go straight. We don't want it to go crooked when we throw. We want it to go straight. The next thing, a more advanced skill, is to start with our feet side by side. And if my right hand is the one that's going to be tossing the object, and I need more power, I can step with my left foot. So I'm going to step with the opposite foot and make it smooth. This is the motion we use for a lot of sports. Opposite arm, opposite leg, and notice my arm goes straight. I'll show you from the side so you can see how that looks. So right hand, left leg, throw. The next thing I want to talk about is follow through. A lot of people don't understand the importance of follow through. Follow through means after you let go of the object, in most sports, you want to continue your hand, your arm, your foot in that same direction. So if I'm throwing from the side, once I release here, I want my hand to keep coming up. So I'm going to throw and keep the hand coming up. That action is called follow through, and it's very important in most sports. You may be wondering, what are you going to use to throw? Well, a lot of sports use a ball. There's horseshoes, there's different things like that. But at home, we have socks. Okay, this is a really good thing to use to practice, because we can fold them up. They're not going to bounce and run away when they land or you're aiming for a target. Go ahead, talk to your mom and dad, see if you have two or three or four sets of old socks, and then come on back. Okay, so the first activity we can do is just simply toss back and forth to a partner, or if you don't have a partner, you can toss to a bucket. Check this out. The next thing you can do is play a game called Advance the Bucket. I like to make mark with chalk on the ground about 3 feet apart with a start line. If you don't have any chalk, you can use some other markers like I did here. I'm using shoes so you can see where the next place to advance the bucket is. So at the start line, I'll have the different objects in my hand, the socks or the ball or whatever. 3 or 4 of them would be great. I'm going to toss the ball into the bucket. If I make it into the bucket, I'm going to run to the bucket, advance the bucket 1 step, run back to the start line, and then toss again. I'm going to continue in this manner until I make the make a shot in all of the buckets, however far you want to go. The best thing about this is you should time yourself. Start the timer, have your friend or mom or dad time you, and see how long it takes you to make 1 bucket or 1 toss into each one of the buckets. Here we go. Here's how it works. Hey guys, awesome job. I hope you learned something about underhand throwing, and I hope you enjoy the game. See you next time.